Hi, I'm Britt with Garmin's product support team, and I want to tell you about some exciting changes available with the latest software update for your Epix Gen 2, Fenix 7, or Tactix 7 series adventure watch. You'll automatically receive this update over the next few days if your watch is paired to the Garmin Connect app or if you've enabled Wi-Fi sync. Now let's dive into what's new. First, we're covering the new training and health additions that are now available, starting with HRV status. Your watch will gather your overnight HRV, also known as heart rate variability, providing your trends over time. You'll need to wear your watch while sleeping for about 3 weeks to reveal insights on your HRV status. HRV plays a big part in understanding how your body is responding to stress, strain, or illness. Monitoring it over time will be able to provide you with a more accurate status to suit your lifestyle. HRV status can be added either as a widget glance or can be viewed in the Garmin Connect app. For help adding the widget glance, see our link in the description. Next, let's discuss Training Status 2.0. Your training status will now include your HRV status, activity history, and VO2 max. This will let you know if you're keeping productive, peaking, or strained. In other words, if you miss a scheduled workout but are still active, your watch will account for this into your training status. You can learn more about Training Status 2.0 by visiting the link in the description. Along with Training Status 2.0, we've included Training Readiness, which measures various daily factors, including your sleep, training load, and HRV status, to determine how prepared you are for each day you train. To learn more about the science behind Training Readiness, see the link in the description. The Race Day widget will help you keep track of how long you have before your race and help you manage your training. To set up the race event and to learn more about the Race Day widget, see our Using the Race Day Widget video. Next, we'll cover Cycling Ability, which measures your cycling data, including your history, power readings, and VO2, to provide you with feedback based on your conditioning. You'll need to train for a week with a power meter and heart rate strap before you'll receive Cycling Ability feedback. The last training and health addition is HRM Confidence and Training Metrics. In the unforeseen event you lose heart rate during your activity, you could receive inaccurate measurements for your activity. For example, if your heart rate strap was not ready to transmit data, or if the battery is dying. HRM Confidence will detect that there is an inaccuracy in the activity, and it accounts for this as part of your training metrics when using an HRM Pro or HRM Pro Plus strap. The next section we'll cover is the new activity support additions. The first topic is full e-bike support. Using an e-bike activity will allow you to see your e-bike's range and battery left when paired to the watch. For help pairing your compatible e-bike, see our FAQ in the description. Now we'll discuss SatIQ. When your activity satellite settings are set to auto-select, our SatIQ technology will determine the optimal GPS mode based on your environment. With this feature enabled, you will receive maximum GPS accuracy and battery life. To learn more about SatIQ, see the link in the description. Next, we'll discuss the new fish activity. Adding the fish activity to your activities list will allow you to keep track of your timeout fishing, catches including location, routing to locations, and view the sunrise and sunset information right from your watch. The last activity support addition is Reference Point. This new app provides a line of sight and bearing back to location. The location can be set as a current location, a set compass bearing, or from one of your previously saved locations. This section will cover some of the notable interface changes to simplify how to view data. The first addition we'll look at is Glance Folders. With Glance Folders, you can combine glances into a single glance to quickly view data and to reduce the length of your glance loop. To add your glances into a folder, just open the Edit menu and add Create Folder. Then you can choose the glance apps you want to add into your folder. Once completed, select Done to view your new glance folder. With the vast number of activity types to choose from, adding activities into your activities list can take some time to complete. To make this process easier, activities will be grouped into sports types to allow you to quickly locate the activities to add. In this last section, we'll cover some additions available to you in the Garmin Connect app. The first feature we'll jump into is Advanced Multisport Editing. After completing a triathlon or other multisport activity, you can open the activity in the Garmin Connect app, and you'll have the option to trim the start or stop time of each sport. Thanks for taking the time to learn about the new features on the latest software for your Garmin smartwatch. To learn more about your product, check out our other videos, or please visit support.garmin.com.